Right, so here we are again for another video of my Kerbal Space Program career mode videos, where today we are going to do some more atmospheric flying. So let's head into the SPH. And I've been thinking a bit of what to do, is maybe do some flying some planes, but I came up with the idea to use a helicopter, and yeah, up to now I couldn't really wrap my head around building helicopters, not with like this one with the Airplane Plus mod, and especially not with the breaking ground parts. I have tried it a couple of times, but it always was in some various forms of failure, usually catastrophic. And so what we are going to do now is load up this little, it is called Chieftain helicopter that I downloaded from Kerbal X, with experiments, and just fly it a bit around the KSC, like we have done with the airplane that I built and that in the end did not fly. So we were just rolling it around at the KSC, and yeah, we're going to use all this compact experiments. Let's see, we still have 6 parts left, so we can use this one too, and the thermometer and the barometer, and do we have everything? Yes, we do. So we could also, I'm afraid that if we, let's just keep it that way, and as true select, I mean this is as far as I got with building planes with building helicopters with Airplane Plus, that like the rotor gives a thrust vector similar to other engines, and then you have to align the center of mass and so on, but usually they were unstable and underpowered and everything. So we are going to select Valentina Kerman as pilot, because I think up to now Jebediah Kerman flew 5 missions and Valentina only 1, so let's spread it a little bit equal. And yeah, also we are going to select Bob Kerman, the scientist, so yeah, so he can also get to fly a little bit. So anyway, let's see, it will take 50 days to build, because up to now the SPH is at a low upgrade level. And yeah, we will build only 1. So let's build it. Leave. Do not save. And here it is. Warp to complete. Okay, so let's also warp to the next morning, because I like to fly at daytime. And launch. We will have Valentina Kerman and Bob Kerman. It's looking good, so let's go. The For Science mod enabled, which of course comes very handy when doing things like this. And let's activate SAS, because we need that with helicopters. And actually I kinda liked the way that the last video with the satellites went unintentionally, where I had to do the or some part of the commenting in while editing the video. And maybe I will do that with some more future videos, but for now I decided to again do the commenting while recording, because when flying helicopters there is a very high danger of crashes, or actually I will crash it eventually, I already know that. And so anyway, we have activated SAS, so let's set it to full thrust, where you can actually see with the thrust how the pitch of the rotor blades is changing. So yeah, let's go. Collected the signs for being landed on the runway. And let's head over to the other buildings of the base. And actually the reason that I decided to fly a helicopter instead of a plane is that now that very soon we will have to upgrade the KSC, at least some of its facilities. And I wanted to take or to record some videos of helicoptering over the level 1 KSC for some kind of like highlights video that I want to do over a long time, and then like having a lot of short clips with cut together and with music and everything. Yeah, so for the very beginning I wanted to have the level 1 facilities visible. Maybe like this. Yeah, I just thought that helicopter we are going to crash. No, we didn't. But now we did. A helicopter would be like the perfect thing to record that. I do not know if we can, like, if we now recover it to the SPH, and if we then could repair that, because like I say, I'm horrific at building helicopters. So let's just do the I've collected 28 science reports. So let's just do the normal recovery. Get the refunds for what is left of our helicopter. And we got 120 something science points. Maybe I should have said that when it was on the screen. And get 25,000 funds for refund. And they both got some research ribbons, and let's close that. So we can also recover this debris, and as you can see we have less science than we had before, but much more funds, because I did some other small part testing contracts, and we got some advance payments for a big co or two big contracts that we are going to tackle in the next episode. And yeah, and I did some more research in the R&D. So let's go into the space plane hangar again. And okay, actually we did autosave the helicopter, so we can just fly it again. If there was any crew capacity on it, let's try if we now got some. Yes, we did. So we can select Valentina Kerman and this time Bill Kerman. And again, build it. We build two of them, so let's strap that one. And again, leave and then time warp 50 days ahead. But we can see if we can. But anyway, we couldn't accept any contracts because we have two of them active. So let's. Where is it? Select this one. And warp to complete. And I don't even know why we suddenly got some science added, but anyway, this is looking good, and launch. But maybe we have should we should have warped to the next morning, so let's do that now. That is Joule rising with the distant object enhancement mod. Let's actually warp until afternoon, about like, oh geez, it's already evening, well, late afternoon, about like this. So activate SAS, full thrust, and let's go. If we can do a controlled landing this time. Actually, I originally wanted to do some helicopter flights much later as a means of like training for the moon landings. But yeah, so we are doing the helicopter flights now. Always like I'm flying stable and it is looking good until at some point I just suddenly lose control. So let's hold it a bit steady to get some nice shots for this this highlights video that I want to take. Oh, and we have a failure from the Dangit mod, but luckily we have yes, of course, we need to land to fix things if we do not crash. Yeah, now we get the nose up. So let's turn around and head back to the KSC. It's always like the tricky part was helicopters, or generally any vertical landing craft, is to kill off all the horizontal velocity. But now this, actually it is not looking that all that bad. Yeah, if I wanted to land on the roof on the VAB, we would have failed already, but now we have successfully landed. So, good thing we have an engineer on board. We can climb out. And where is it? Take a few spare parts. Let's see if... yep, we have successfully repaired the battery. now all that's left to do is climb the board again. And what you can do is grab here and board. So I don't even know if I mentioned before that I'm playing with the Dangit mod, but you have now seen it in action. So we can see if we can do this short hop over there and land on the roof of the tracking station main building, which will be one of the first buildings to be upgraded in order to allow mission planning and all that other stuff. But the more I think about it, the more I start to think that maybe it would be some kind of a nice challenge to fly a probe into, at least into moon orbit, without the ability to plan maneuver nodes. So we have sort of landed on the tracking station building. We did not land well, but we did land. So let's go. And maybe fly... do not fly sideways at first. Actually, we can see if the... or we can take a look if the... we have crashed again, but anyway, what we have seen is that... or what I wanted to see, and I did see, is that the observatory over there from the research bodies, Magda, does not count as its own biome like the other facilities do. And actually what the research bodies mod does is like hide some of the celestial bodies, and you have to discover them at first. And maybe it still flies, no it doesn't. So anyway, we can recover the wreckage yet again. So recover vessel. Do the normal recovery again. And we have collected 215 science points this time, so almost twice as much as with the first flight. Again, get about 25, or we should get the exact same amount of refunds, or nearly the same amount, because we broke the exact same things, but only this time we have less spare parts and maybe less fuel that we can recover. So let's complete that one. And both of them got the Research 5 ribbon, and I think I already mentioned that, in my opinion, the amount of science points that you need to, or that a Kerbal needs to collect in order to get this research ribbons from the Final Frontier mod is way too low, because I think the highest research ribbon is with the Research 10 is with like 2000 science points, and I do collect 2000 science points, or I will collect 2000 science points later on my Apollo. Maybe you have seen the video of my Apollo Saturn V replica, and with the improved version of that one that carries a lot of mod parts. You can collect 2000 science points in one moon mission. I can remember the Duna mission that I also uploaded a video of, crossed out at about, I think, 23,000 science points. So anyway, let's close that window. And yeah, the other debris has already been automatically recovered yet. Has already been automatically recovered. So anyway, I think this is a good point to end this this episode. And as usual, if you have As usual, if you have liked it, you can feel free to leave a like and subscribe to my channel, and you can also subscribe to my main channel, which I will link here. And I hope to see you again in the next episode, where I'm going to launch two more satellites, one of them in stationary orbit. So I hope to see you there.